Hi everyone, how are you doing? So in this video we're going to be going over Hold Me While You Wait by Lewis Capaldi. So if you want to play along with the original song, just make sure you've got your capo sitting on the second fret. Alright, so to get started, what we're going to do is we're just going to be playing our A major chord. So that's your first finger in the fourth string on the second fret, your middle finger in the third string in the second fret, and then your third finger, second string, second fret, and that's your A major chord there. Now, for this song, you're going to be doing the same strumming pattern the whole way through the song, so it doesn't change in any part at all. So you're just going to be doing downstrokes the whole way through the song, and you're going to be doing palm muting as well. So to do that, all you're going to do is with your strumming hand, you're just going to gently touch the strings, so you get that sound there. So you're not putting any pressure on the strings at all. You're just going to be slightly touching them, so you get that sound there. And that's all you need to do, and that's just how you're going to be playing the song the whole way through. So you've got your A major chord, and you're just going to be playing this here. It's all downstrokes, and you're going to be doing that for 4 bars, so 32 downstrokes. It'll probably be easier to count 4 bars than getting up to 32. So you've got that there, and then once you've done that, you're going to go to your C sharp minor chord, which is your first finger on the fifth string in the fourth fret, your third finger on the fourth string on the sixth fret, your pinky on the third string in the sixth fret, and then your middle finger, second string, fifth fret. And that's your C sharp minor chord there. Alright, you're just going to be doing that for 16 downstrokes or 2 bars. And then you're going to go on to your D sus 2 chord after that, which is your D major chord, just without your middle finger. So it's your first finger, third string, second fret, third finger, second string, third fret, and then just leave your middle finger off, you're just leaving the first string open, and that's your D sus 2 chord there. So you're just going to be doing that for 16 downstrokes, and that's your first bar there, okay? So I'll play that again for you just to so you can hear how it sounds again. If you want to, feel free to play along so you can get used to the chord changes and everything there, and then we'll go through the rest of the song. So you start off with your A major chord, then C sharp minor, and D sus 2. So you do the chord, you do the verse twice, and then what we do is we go into our pre-chorus, and we're going to be playing our F sharp chord. So it's your first finger on the sixth string in the second fret, third finger on the fifth string in the fourth fret, and then your pinky on the fourth string in the fourth fret, and that's your F sharp there. So you're just going to be doing 8 downstrokes for this one. To your A major, you're going to be doing 8 downstrokes for that as well, and then up to your E major, which is your first finger, third string, first fret, third finger, fourth string, second fret, and then your middle finger, fifth string, second fret, and that's your E major chord there. And you're just going to be doing 16 downstrokes for that there, and you do that twice again. So it's your F sharp, A major, major, then again F sharp, E major, then E major. Right, and then we go on to our chorus, which you go back to your A major, and you can do 16 downstrokes for that. On to your C sharp minor again, so you're going to do another 16 for that. To your F sharp for 16 downstrokes as well, and then your E major for 16. Now you're just going to be doing the chorus one, so it's just your A major, C sharp minor, F sharp, to your verse after that. So your verse, the chords are just the exact same as it was the first time round, so you're just going to do your A major, C sharp minor in your D sus2, but you're just going to be doing that once, then straight into the pre-chorus, which again is the same chord progression as the last time we've done it. So you said F sharp, A major, E major, and you're going to do that once, but this time with your E major, you're just going to be doing 9 downstrokes. So you do your F sharp for 8, A major for 8, E major for 9. Then back onto the chorus, and again, chorus will be the exact same as before. So your A major for 16 downstrokes, C sharp minor for 16, F sharp for 16, and E major for 16. But this time you do the chorus twice, so you just go back and play the exact same chord progression, the exact same amount of times for the second time round. And then we go on to the bridge. So there's two ways you can play the bridge. I prefer just doing one downstroke and then just going on to the next one, but you can keep that strumming pattern going for the bridge as well. So to play it, you're just playing your D sus, and you just do one, well, the way I play it is I just do one downstroke for 4 beats, and then I'll go on to the next one. So it'll just be 1, 2, 3, 4, E major, 1, 2, 3, 4, F sharp, 2, 3, 4, A major, 1, 2, 3, 4, then back to your D sus2, 1, 2, 3, 4, E major, 1, 2, 3, 4, F sharp, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you're just going to be doing the bridge once. And then once you've done that there, you're going to go into the chorus. And this time, you're going to be playing it 3 times. And then once you've finished it, you just finish off with one downstroke on the A major there. Okay, so it's your A major for 16, C sharp minor for 16, F sharp, 16, for 16, and just finish off on your A major. And to finish off the chorus, you do that 3 times, and then once you've done your E major chord, just for the 16 downstrokes, you just do one strum in the A major chord, just to finish that off, and that's you there. Okay, so that is Hold Me While You Wait by Lewis Capaldi. So I'll let you get on and have a practice with that. A good way to practice the songs as well is if you have a listen to the song without playing it, don't worry about playing along with the song or anything, just listen to it a few times, just itself, so you can get the song nice and fresh in your head. Pick up your guitar and have a practice at it, just you yourself, and then you can have a wee try and play along with the song as well. This is a good way to practice it, just to get onto playing along with the track there for you. So if you listen to the song just a few times itself, get it stuck into your head, play it just yourself without any backing tracks or anything, and then try along and play with the song. I'll also have the tabs up for this song on my Facebook page as soon as possible. So if you go on to facebook.com/McNaughtonGuitar, if you give that page a like, you can be kept up to date with all the tabs and everything that I'll be doing there. And if you could also quick subscribe to the music channel, the YouTube channel, sorry, that would be a huge help for me as well. I'll put up as many videos as I can for you, so if you click subscribe, you will be kept up to date with all the videos and everything that I'll be doing there, so that'll be a huge help for me. So yeah, I'll let you go and practice that song, and I'll have another video up for you as soon as possible. Bye!